Hey everyone, this time on Tim Talks Audio, Studio One's device block size and when to use what. The block size, also known as the buffer size, is the amount of time your computer and Studio One will take to process the ins and outs of your sound card or interface. You can find the device block size in the Audio Device Control Panel. The hotkey on Mac is Command, comma, and on PC, it's Control and comma. When the dialog box opens, you'll want to search Audio Setup from the top menu. Then your audio device will pop up. This is where you can change your sound card or audio interface, adjust your device block size, and enable or disable the release of the audio device in the background. The device block size is a drop-down menu that has a range of choices, but how do I know which one to pick? There are different reasons to change your block size to be either higher or lower. If you were recording a vocal, for example, you would want to use the smallest available block size to minimize input delay. Be careful, though. Too small of a block size, and your device won't have time to process the audio on the way in, and you may experience some clicks and pops. Adversely, if you have a large session with lots of processing going on, like plugins and virtual instruments, and too small of a block size, your audio interface may struggle trying to keep up with all the processing that's going on. A good reminder is a small block size for tracking to reduce input delay, and a large block size for mixing and editing to allow for more processing power. That's all for now. If you found this informative, please like this video. If you have any questions about how to use Studio One more effectively, please leave a comment. Thanks for watching.